Clownfish are little, colorful fish that look great in any home saltwater tank. With a little care, attention, and knowledge, they can be easily bred at home. Here are some simple techniques for breeding clownfish in your own aquarium. Make sure you understand the basics of saltwater aquarium care. Breeding fish is a chore best left to those familiar with saltwater tank setup and management. While rearing these fish isn't difficult, it does require some knowledge of fish nutrition and life cycles, as well as supplies for optimal tank filtration and ecosystem growth. Before you start breeding fish, you should read how to start a saltwater aquarium or how to start a marine reef aquarium. Purchase a mated pair from an aquarium store. Clownfish are external breeders, meaning the female fish lays the eggs and the male fish fertilizes them. To do this, you will need a couple of clownfish that are already linked or mated. Many aquarium stores sell mated pairs for breeding clownfish. If they don't have any in stock, they can usually order some for you. Ask away. Form a matched pair. Another option is to bond two baby clownfish yourself. Begin with two young clownfish. One of the wonderful things about clownfish is that they are born neither male nor female. Use any pair. Fish only become male or female as they age. The sex of your fish is determined by their dominance when fighting. The dominant fish becomes a female, while the less dominant becomes a male. In a large tank with many clownfish, only one bonded pair will form. The most dominant female will be replaced by a man. The rest are sexless. If you want to avoid fighting and have the fish change sex as early as possible, purchase one clownfish that is larger than the other. Keep your tanks water clean. Clownfish are not as sensitive to environmental conditions as other fish. However, clean water encourages breeding. Incorporate plants and rocks. Adding anemone to the aquarium helps calm the clownfish. This is optional but will boost the chances of your pair breeding. Your tank should also feature living rock. Coral reefs are built on live rock, which is found in the water. The living rock provides hiding spots for the fish and a surface for the clownfish to lay and care for their eggs. Timers for aquarium lighting. Keep it light during the day and dark at night. Consistency promotes relaxation and spawning in clownfish. Recognize spawning-related changes in clownfish behavior. A thickening of the female, the larger of your two fish, indicates she is about to lay eggs. Their mouths and fins may also start cleaning the rocks for the eggs. Watch for clownfish eggs. The eggs will be orange in color and will be adhered to the rocks. The male clownfish will care for them, swimming around and aerating them with his fins. He may also pick off the dead. Examine the clownfish eggs. Clownfish eggs grow in phases. They start out orange but change to the eggs will hatch in 7 to 10 days. For the first week, feed the fry live rotifers. Many species feed on rotifers. Then you can start adding live brine shrimp. Baby clownfish only eat live food. Once the eggs are laid, set up a hatchling tank. A 10-gallon tank will do for the hatchlings. Rather than a big filtration system, go for an air stone that emits small bubbles or another moderate oxygenation method. A little too much filtering could kill your fry. You must also offer adequate lighting for the fry, as they will be hunting for food with poor vision. One light bulb is enough, and it should be as dispersed as possible. Move hatchlings to another tank. Some breeders transfer the eggs before they hatch, but most wait until the hatchlings emerge before moving them. As a rule, clownfish devour their own eggs and hatchlings, so keep the fry apart. Prepare the additional tank ahead of time. Feed your clownfish fry. The embryos in the egg sac use the yolk for energy, but after they hatch, they need nourishment fast. Rotifers, tiny aquatic invertebrates, should be fed to clownfish hatchlings. These are sometimes found at aquarium stores, but check with yours first. Many clownfish breeders prefer breeding rotifers for their hatchlings over purchasing them from an aquarium store. If you don't have enough of these, your hatchlings will die. Change 20 to 50% of their water daily. This helps maintain the water clean and allows the hatchlings to view the rotifers they need to eat. Expect some fry to die during the transition from fry to fish. One of the most difficult adjustments in a clownfish's life is from larva to juvenile. To help them grow quickly, switch their diet from rotifers to live brine shrimp. To maintain saltwater reef aquariums healthy, you can add fertilizers to the water. Observe your fry grow into juveniles. If your fish survives the transformation, you should start seeing the clownfish's characteristic color develop. They should keep growing swiftly, so keep feeding them.